How does screen resolution work? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. This is an interesting topic, not because it isn't easy to describe, but the description doesn't necessarily match what we expect to have happen when we are playing with our screen resolution. What we're going to do is actually use screen resolution in Windows and show you what the different types of settings look like and what kind of an effect they have on what you see on the screen. So let's first switch right over to Windows 10, where I have my screen set up to be 1920 pixels wide by 1080 pixels high. If that sounds at all familiar to you, that is traditional high-definition television. The videos that I produce, both for YouTube and out on Vimeo, they're all produced to be 1920 by 1080 pixels. If you have the opportunity, this video might be best watched at its full resolution. So here we are. We've got 1920 by 1080. I've got, you can see the start menu takes up a certain amount of space on the screen. And for this copy of Windows, 1920 by 1080 is the ideal resolution because that's the resolution I'm producing the video at. It's comparable to the ideal resolution for your monitor. It's like I had a monitor that was exactly 1920 by 1080 pixels capable. It couldn't do any more. That's how many pixels it has. So what happens if we change the resolution? What if we tell Windows to display something other than what my monitor is capable of? I'm right-clicking on the desktop. We'll go over to Display Settings. And as we scroll down here, you can see 1920 by 1080 is the current resolution. If I drop this list down, you can see that there are a number of alternatives. They're all smaller than 1920 by 1080 because that's the maximum my monitor, in this case, is able to do. I could choose any of those smaller ones. You can see that there's one recommended. 800 by 600, by definition, is the absolute smallest that Windows now supports. Used to support smaller, doesn't anymore. If I now switch it to 1024 by 768, and I say keep the changes, you'll notice that things got weird. So in this one, you can see that we've got 1920 by 1080 display, but our window that's being displayed by Windows doesn't fill up the entire thing. What's happened here is that the monitor has scaled the window to fit the available space without changing the aspect ratio. In other words, it scaled up the 768 to be 1080 high and then made it wider proportionately. So it's still the same ratio of height to width just to fill up the available space. That's why we have what are called pillar boxes on either side, the black bars that you'll see on either side of Windows display here. Now, if I bring up the start menu again, you'll see that it's taking up way more of the space. What's interesting about this is that things look bigger. In other words, the start menu visually on your screen, if you're looking at this at 1920 by 1080, is physically bigger. But the images aren't as sharp. They're using fewer pixels to display the images. That's the result of this scaling that happens. Now, there's another approach to what happens when you use a lower resolution, and that's called stretching. Now, you'll notice that we're using up the entire screen, but everything seems out of proportion. What was square, like say the Spotify icon here, the Spotify tile on the start menu, is now rectangular. It's wider than it is high. That's what happens when you stretch something to fit the screen when it's not the exact same aspect ratio. You've made things bigger, but you've also made things weird. You've also made things distort. Now, the reason that all is, whether it be stretching to fill the entire screen or scaling to fill as much of the screen as it can without changing the aspect ratio, that's all something that's being performed by the monitor. The monitor knows the least about what's going on. It just says, hey, somebody's throwing me a bunch of pixels. It's smaller than my screen. My screen is this big. I will do something to fit the screen, fill the screen. That's fine. And what happens will depend on exactly which monitor you have and how it decides to handle the situation. Usually what people are trying to do is make things bigger, make things look bigger on the screen. Honestly, Windows knows way, way more about what's going on than your monitor ever will. Let Windows do the work. How do you do that? Well, let's go back to our display resolution, display settings, and we will go ahead and set it back to 1920 by 1080. Now, you'll notice that even though 1024 by 768 was quote-unquote recommended, it's not the best resolution. The best resolution you want to choose for your display is always the maximum resolution, or what's sometimes called the native resolution, of the display you're connected to. My display is capable of 1920 by 1080. That's what this should be set to. If your display does something different, like 3840 by 2160, which is Ultra HD or UHD, use that. Yes, things will for a moment look really, really small on that screen. The icons will be tiny. The text might be tiny. We've got a different solution for that. And that's this thing called scaling that's right up above. You'll notice that mine's set to 125. That's actually a choice that I made earlier. If I set it to 100, all my text got smaller. It's still using the full screen. It's using the 1920 by 1080. But everything changed to be back to 100%. The other direction is great. 175%. Boom. Now all of a sudden things got big. You're still using the whole screen at its highest resolution, but we're scaling everything so that they look bigger. Everything looks sharp as is possible on this specific screen. So the answer to making things bigger is to let Windows do the work. Change the screen resolution, or set the screen resolution, to be whatever is supported natively by your hardware, by your monitor. Then use scaling to change things to be the size that you want. I happen to want 125%. So what this all boils down to is that making things bigger can actually mean a couple of different things. If you let the screen scale things for you, it may not use the entire screen, and things will be a little bit fuzzier. If you let the screen stretch things for you, well, you'll use the whole screen, but not only will things be a little fuzzier, they'll actually be out of proportion. If you let Windows scale things for you by setting your display resolution to be the proper resolution for your screen, and then use the scale and layout function to change the size, that will give you the maximum screen usage with the maximum clarity. I hope that gets you to where you want to be. I hope that gets you a screen that looks as best as it possibly can at a size that works for you. For updates, for comments, for a few more examples and some pictures of this, visit askleo.com/4245. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is AskLeo.com. Thanks for watching.